The tutorial will demonstrate how to use the same XLOOKUP formula to return values for multiple items. The XLOOKUP function is the improved version of VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. XLOOKUP function is used when you need to find things in a table or arrange by row. The difference between VLOOKUP and XLOOKUP is that XLOOKUP can search for a return value regardless of which side the return column is on. It can look for a return value left or right of the lookup value, while VLOOKUP could only look from left to right. Both functions support exact and approximate matching. XLOOKUP has three basic and three optional parameters. The three basic parameters are lookup value, the value you are looking for, lookup area, the range to search for the lookup value, and return area, the range that contains the return values. To learn about the optional parameters of the XLOOKUP function, check out my YouTube channel for more XLOOKUP tutorials. XLOOKUP function makes it easier to find multiple items based on a lookup value without changing the formula. For the purpose of this tutorial, we have five products with their product IDs, product names, departments, and prices. We would like to know for product ID 506, the product name, department, and price. First, we define the lookup value. In our case, the product ID 506, located in cell F4. The lookup area is the range from A2 to A6, and the return area will be the range from B2 to D6, meaning XLOOKUP will look at both column B, D, and C for an exact match based on the lookup value. By pressing Enter, you see that XLOOKUP automatically returned three values, the product name, department, and price. Currently, XLOOKUP can only spill in one direction, either across columns or down to rows. To return non-contiguous columns, you need to use a nested choose function in the range area. For example, if you would like to learn only the product name and price, then you will need to use a nested choose function in the return area of XLOOKUP function. First, we define the lookup value as the product ID in cell F7. Secondly, we define the lookup area, which is the range from A2 to A6. For the return area, we need to nest the choose function. Choose function has two arguments. Index number specifies the value argument to be selected. In our case, we wish to select both value 1 and value 2. As such, we require to square brackets in which we write 1 and 2. This will tell Excel to select both value 1 and 2. Then the second arguments are value ranges. As value 1, we will have the product name. So from B2 to B6. As value 2, we will have the price in range from D2 to D6. By pressing Enter, XLOOKUP will return two items, the product name and price without department. To learn how to use the XLOOKUP function to look up values not only vertically but also horizontally, check out my YouTube channel. There you can find additional tutorials on how to use XLOOKUP. Thank you for watching. If you liked the tutorial, please subscribe to my YouTube channel for more Excel for Mac tutorials.